Ice and Barbara, the church shares your joy and warmly welcomes you, together with your families and friends, as today you establish between yourselves a lifelong partnership. For believers, God is the source of love and fidelity, because God is love. So let us listen attentively to his word, and let us humbly pray to him that he may grant you your heart's desire and fulfill every one of your prayers. Oh God, who in creating the human race willed that man and wife should be one, join, we pray, in a bond of inseparable love these your servants, who are to be united in the covenant of marriage, so that as you make their love fruitful, they may become by your grace witnesses to charity itself. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated as we listen to our first reading.
Yeah.
You got it.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. When one finds a worthy wife, her value is far beyond pearls. Her husband, entrusting his heart to her, has an unfailing promise. She brings him good and not evil all the days of her life. She obtains wool and flax and makes cloth with skillful hands. She puts her hands to the distaff and her fingers ply the spindle. She reaches out her hands to the poor and extends her arms to the needy. Charm is deceptive and beauty fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a reward of her labors, and let her works praise her at the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts. But I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongue, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have faith as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interests. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Please stand.
That's such a nice job.
Looks like he's got his back to everybody, But that's not the idea. The idea is that we're all facing God together, same direction, and lifting up our prayers to God. So that's what we're going to be doing today, lifting up our prayers for Barbara and Heiss as they join in holy matrimony, as they are united as husband and wife before God. So, unfortunately, I didn't get to know y'all as much as I would have liked. Y'all seem like a really amazing couple, and I'm really happy for y'all. And basically, the call to marriage, it's a beautiful calling so that the husband and wife together can become saints and grow closer to God and one day go to heaven. So, what y'all are being called to, it's not just to make each other happy, which we hope will happen, but together you help each other have joy by looking towards God together, looking towards Jesus, walking hand in hand towards the Lord, helping each other fall in love with Jesus more and more each day. And the way that basically he wants to work is to help you learn to love like he loves through each other. So all of us are called to be saints. I'm called to be a saint. Every single one of you is called to be a saint. And saint means that we're holy. We have a heart like God's heart. We become transformed to be like God, little by little, and in our love, in our heart. And so when we die, we hope to be ready to be united with him. And that's what heaven is. Is perfect union with God. This life here on earth, then, is all about, the purpose isn't to get a lot of money or fame or all the stuff that we always are searching so hard after. What we're really yearning for is that union with God. And the Lord is inviting us to be transformed day by day to be more like him, have a heart like his heart. In other words, it's like this. Our life here on earth is a school of love, like it's an opportunity for us to learn how to love like God loves. And marriage is a very beautiful calling in which a husband and wife can learn to love as God loves and become saints. So, Barbara, you're called to help Heiss become a saint. Be the best man he can possibly be, the saint that he's called to be. Help rub off his rough edges little by little, his imperfections, help him grow spiritually. And same thing, Heiss, you're called to help Barbara become a saint. Help, with God's grace, her rough edges, her imperfections, to be smoothed over and perfected day by day in God's grace. So, by your daily sacrifices for each other, and especially, God willing, God will bless you with wonderful family, with children. Well, when the children come, even more. All these opportunities to become less selfish and more selfless. More a heart like God's heart. So that's what you're doing today, is you're saying, I'm committing before God to give myself entirely to Heiss, to Barbara. For the rest of my life, I'm going to give a total gift of self, holding nothing back. And in that gift of self, God is going to transform you day by day into the saint that he's calling you to be. So it's a beautiful, exciting moment. And all of you who are married, it's a great opportunity as we celebrate this wedding today to kind of reflect on the calling that you have. I don't know, maybe you haven't thought about it in a while, that God's calling you to help your spouse become a saint. That together you're supposed to walk towards Jesus, hand in hand, help each other one day go to heaven. So it's an opportunity for you to renew your own vows and recommit your own self to your marriage and to your walk together with Christ. So I invite Barbara and Heiss to come forward, please, as we exchange the vows.
You got it.
Thank you.
Dearly beloved, you have come together here before a minister of the church and in the presence of the community so that your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal, and your love be enriched with his blessing so that you may have strength to be faithful for each other forever, faithful to each other forever, and to assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Maybe I have, I know. Heis and Barbara, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly?
I have.
Are you prepared as you follow the path of marriage to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live?
I am.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
I am.
Since it is your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and his church.
It's okay.
It's okay. It's okay. It's okay.
I, Heis. Take you, Barbara.
To be my wife.
I promise to be faithful to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. To love you and to honor you. All the days of my life. I, Barbara.
Take you, Heis.
To be my husband. I promise to be faithful to you. In good times and in bad. In sickness and in health. To love you and to honor you. All the days of my life. May the Lord in his kindness strengthen the consent you have declared before the church and graciously bring to fulfillment his blessing within you. What God joins together, let no one put asunder. And so in a moment I will say, let us bless the Lord. And if you could all say, thanks be to God. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Give to each other as a sign of love and fidelity. Barbara, receive this ring. As a sign of my love and fidelity.
Heis, receive this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity. Please stand as we lift our prayers to God for this newly married husband and wife.
Is that wrong hand?
Your response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. That God will bless these faithful Christians, Heis and Barbara, newly joined in holy matrimony, and that they may always enjoy health and well-being, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That he will bless our covenant as he chose to sanctify marriage at Cana in Galilee, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That they be granted perfect and fruitful love, peace and strength, and that they bear faithful witness to the love of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Christian people may grow in virtue day by day, and that all who are burdened by any need may receive the help of grace from above, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the grace of the sacrament of matrimony will be renewed by the Holy Spirit in all married persons here present, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you for Hyas and Barbara. We ask that you richly bless them in their marriage, and that in all that they do, they may give glory and honor to you. All this we ask through Christ, your Son, our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated as we prepare the altar. Brothers and sisters, in my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, we pray, O Lord, the offering made on the occasion of the sealing of the sacred bond of marriage. And just as your goodness is its origin, may your providence guide its course through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have forged the covenant of marriage as a sweet yoke of harmony and an unbreakable bond of peace, so that the chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonder of this twofold design, that while the birth of children brings beauty to the world, their rebirth and baptism gives increase to the church through Christ our Lord. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Be mindful also, Lord, of Heiss and Barbara, whom you have brought to their wedding day, so that by your grace they may abide in mutual love and in peace. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Now let us humbly invoke God's blessing upon this bride and groom, that in his kindness he may favor with his help those on whom he has bestowed the bond of marriage. Holy Father, maker of the whole world, who created man and woman in your own image and willed that their union be crowned with your blessing, we humbly beseech you for these your servants who are joined today in the marriage covenant. May your abundant blessing, Lord, come down upon this bride, Barbara, and upon Heis, her companion for life. And may the power of your Holy Spirit set their hearts aflame from on high, so that living out the gift of matrimony, they may be known for the integrity of their conduct and be recognized as virtuous parents. In happiness, may they praise you, O Lord. In sorrow, may they seek you out. May they have the joy of your presence to assist them in their toil, and know that you are near to comfort them in their need. And after a happy old age, together with the circle of friends that surround them, may they come to the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. In just a moment, we will be distributing Holy Communion, and just as a friendly explanation, we Catholics believe that the bread and wine actually is changed by Jesus into himself during the Mass, so it actually is Jesus and not a symbol, and so for that reason, we believe one needs to be Catholic and spiritually prepared to receive Holy Communion. So if you're not Catholic or you're not spiritually prepared, we're very happy that you're here, and you can come forward for a blessing, which means I can pray a little prayer over you, and you can just indicate that by crossing your arms like that.
Please join in singing the communion hymn.
Body of Christ.
Lord, you have come to the seashore. At number 410.
Stay there.
Sorry.
we pray, Almighty God, that the power of the sacrament we have received may find growth in these your servants, and that the effects of the sacrifice we have offered may be felt by us all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Heis and Barbara, please bow your heads for God's blessing. After each one, if everyone could please say, Amen. May the Lord Jesus Christ, who graced the marriage at Cana by his presence, bless you and your loved ones.
Amen. Amen.
May he who loved the church to the end unceasingly pour his love into your hearts.
Amen. Amen.
May the Lord grant that, bearing witness to faith in his resurrection, you may await with joy the blessed hope to come.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
With joy I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Overgore.
Thank you. alle Nederlanders, Hollanders, dat jullie hier zijn. We're extremely grateful that every one of you has made a very long trip to be here with us and to share the love. And we're extremely grateful for all the help that we got over the past few days, past few weeks, past few months. I want to like to thank the families in particular. Familie Overgooi, dank jullie wel. Super fijn om te weten dat jullie altijd voor ons klaarstaan en dat jullie, nou ja, jullie zijn dan een oceaan verderop, maar het is altijd fijn dat als er iets gebeurt of als er iets aan de hand is, dat in ieder geval Marty er meteen is. En applaus voor Marty. Y mi nueva familia, gracias por todo que han hecho estas semanas, meses. Estoy muy orgulloso para ser que soy parte de tu familia. I'm tired. Y Alida y Manuel, ahora el trabajo está hecho. Disfrútense, relájense. And everybody, if you see Manu and Alida, they've put so much work in. They've let us have their apartment as a storage unit the last couple months. So if you see them do any work tonight, like ask them what they're doing, grab them a drink, and send them back to the dance floor. And last but not least, my beautiful wife. Of course, there wouldn't have been a wedding without you, but also with all the work that you've been done. She's been truly amazing the past 5 years that I've known her, and I really love her. It's been a great day today, and really without all of the work that you put in every day, we wouldn't be standing here. And we have had a year with a lot of ups and downs, mostly ups, but a couple downs as well. I guess that's how marriage goes. So thank you, I love you, and let everybody enjoy the party, and thank you for being here.
Como para nosotros, como nuestra hija.
I'm nervous, and so for this special moment for us and our daughter.
En esta noche tan maravillosa para Barbarita.
And this marvelous night for Barbara.
Queremos nosotros como padre.
Us as a parent.
Desearles lo mejor en esta nueva etapa de la vida.
Would like to wish them the best in this new stage in life.
El tiempo pasa muy rápido.
Time flies by.
Ayer cuando estaba chica. Al poco tiempo, una niña adolescente.
It seems like yesterday when she was a little girl, and shortly after, a teen.
Luchadora de sus sueños, y hoy logrando su sueño de toda una mujer.
A fighter for her dreams, and now accomplishing the dream. Accomplishing her dreams of any woman finding her better half.
Uniendo su vida a su media naranja. Dios los bendiga. Felicidades.
May God bless you both with happiness.
Ahora, como padre, quiero darle la bienvenida a nuestra familia, a ese joven que logró conquistar su corazón.
Now I would like to welcome to our family this young man who won over her heart.
Welcome, Chief Over.
Welcome, G's Over.
I remember the time you guys called us that you're getting married. We were very happy to hear it. Then you guys told me I have to give a speech. And I was speechless. It was a joke of Robin, thank you for that. But no, I had mixed feelings. At first I felt very honored that I have to give the speech at your wedding. But at the same time, I was nervous from that moment till now. Because I don't like to speak for a lot of people, and in English makes it even harder, but I'm gonna give it a try. First, I wanna speak to you, Gijs, my little brother. Now you're doing CrossFit, you're not so little anymore. But you're still my little brother. But also, and the most important thing, you're my best friend. I think our connection is really special. We share a lot of things we really like. I'm talking about, of course, soccer, but also playing FIFA on the PlayStation, watching videos of guilty dogs, and annoying other people, especially Maaike, our sister. But Maaike, you have to know we really love you. With a lot of things, we are exactly the same. But at one thing, we are completely different. I fell in love with a girl in Holland this summer as a teenager. But for you, in Holland, nobody was good enough. Then you went to the US for your study. You called me up one day and said to me you met a special girl. Her name was Barbara. First of all, I was really surprised. After all those years in Holland, you couldn't find anyone. And you were only a couple of months in the US, and you were already fell in love with a girl. But of course, I was really happy for you. The difficult thing of this, we have a long distance relationship as brothers, but it's difficult that we share a lot of things together, but you couldn't show me your girlfriend. But finally in the summer, when we meet up in Vegas, I saw you for the first time in a year, but also I met Barbara. From the first moments in Vegas, when I saw you two, and we did a little bit of tiny gambling, just a little bit, Barbara, only a little bit, but a lot of a little bit, but we did a little bit of tiny gambling, I felt and saw that you two were made for each other. It was nice to know you better, Barbara, and I think we had a great time with the three of us. And now, a couple of years later, we are here for your wedding. First, we celebrate Christmas with both of the families. It was really special to meet all your family. I think you have a lovely family, and I enjoyed every minute of the time together. Dear Barbara, it's difficult sometimes because we can't see each other much often, but you have to know we are really happy with you, and we see how crazy Gijs is with you. You make Gijs really happy, and if Gijs is happy, we are happy. And we are really proud of the fact you are an Overgoor now. You are really, 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 really welcome to our family. Dear Gijs and Barbara, enjoy this day, and I wish you all the love and happiness in the future. I love you both.